Hi everybody, how's it going today? You might want to, when you get on today, just make sure you're putting a little something in the bar comments so we know who's joining us today and we get to say hi. Hi Lori, Leanna, how you doing? Good to see you all those names coming up, it looks good, looks good. We're gonna give it just a minute or two if you wanna get on your mat and get ready and maybe start your breathing. We're gonna take a moment. Sophia, how's it going? Miss you. Hi, Michelle. Good. Hopefully this venue of Four Corners and doing our yoga first live and then joining it on YouTube is working out well for you. Hi, Kim. And hopefully you'll be able to use it anytime you want. And Four Corners has set that up for us to enjoy whenever we need an attitude adjustment, which is my theme today. An attitude adjustment, right? I think we can all use that. Hi, France. Hi, Becky. Good to see you guys. Miss your face too. Hi, Patty. Good. Is Charlie going to join us as well? hi, Kim. Jeannie. Good to see you guys. So we'll get started here in about a minute. I wanted to let you know that, again, we will get going with our breath. So when you're ready, just start some nice deep breaths as I'm welcoming people. Kim, you look good, Kim. Just by the fact that I can see your name up there makes me feel good. So again, today my theme is attitude adjustment. And the other day, just yesterday, I kind of felt like I needed an attitude adjustment. And I thought, what are my tools that I've learned over all my yoga practice and just life experience that helped me kind of shift out of not feeling so bright and with it to feeling more connected to myself and healthier and just having a better attitude. And Janelle, hi Janelle. And you know, there's a couple of things. I think one of the quickest ways to come out of not feeling so good is just find some things that you are thankful for. I'm thankful for you all. Susan, Stephanie, welcome. And just name them in your mind as you start your day off. And again, moving is a good way. It helps the body and the mind to just work better and feel better. And I really believe in getting outside, especially when it's sunny. It's very healing, that fresh air and sun. Again, we're just practicing being a part of it, but other than that, you can get outside and really enjoy. And I always say, look up, look to the tallest tree. It can really, just in that one instant, change your attitude. And then maybe just do some good. What can you do for someone else? Maybe just phone a friend, check in with them, things like that. So we're gonna have an attitude adjustment movement practice today. As always, this is an all levels class and I want you to take it at the level that works for you today, that honors you, that brings about a better feeling and connection to yourself. So join me on the mat when you're ready, easy seated pose. Hi, Kelly, glad you're here. All right, let's get going. So again, this practice is meant for you to modify to your needs. And so as we start with our breath, we're always just working our way in to connecting to whatever it is that's showing up for us today. And let's just take a few breaths. Welcome yourself. Take a nice deep inhale. Long exhale, follow that exhale in through the very center of you, and then expand with another deep inhale, and find that long exhale, bringing that awareness in. One more breath right here, inhale,
Let's just bring our head down, give it a little shake. And when you're ready, bring your hands on the floor and just begin to lean a little bit, even bringing your head side to side in an easy way. Just feeling into the body as you continue to breathe. If you lean into any part of your seated pose and it just feels like it's giving you a little more information, just stay with it a little longer. Just a nice easy movement. When you're ready, you'll turn this into some waves over your head of side bends. Breath coming in nice and deep as you reach up, and then following that exhale to the side bend. So moving at a rate that feels good to you. Some of you maybe practiced a little bit or warmed up a bit before we started today, and I would always suggest that that would be a good idea. Maybe a brisk walk or some breath work, meditation. Just moving around and getting your body moving before our practice. When you're ready, we'll raise our arms over our heads and practice just brightening up our spine and lifting as high as you can. Lace the hands together, bring them behind the head, and let's just bring our thumbs to the sides of our necks and palpitate. So start at the bottom of the neck with your thumb and roll right up to the back edge of the jaw or skull. Do that a few times, and then when you're ready, place your head back into your hands nice and heavy as you look up. Open those eyes wide and bring those elbows apart. Deep breath. Exhale out. Maybe even wave a little bit here, just checking in. And then a big stretch back up over your head, and easy twisting next, just easy, nice. Again, you can move and lean a little bit as you twist. Checking in with your neck as you turn and try to look behind you as well. Let's just do one more to each side and meet me back in the center. And then take a present breath with your hands together in front of your heart. Deep breath in. And a long breath out following it in the awareness of bringing that breath down deep into the center of you. Good. We're going to switch on to our hands and knees next. Take your time. If you need a little extra padding under your knees, you can use a beach blanket or a yoga blanket. And just move organically here, either swinging side to side or doing some barrel rolls. Take your time. Notice what you're feeling. Curl your toes under and sit your body way back, hips pressing over the heels. Push into those hands, straighten your arms, and then lift the fingertips as high as you can. And look at your hands. How much space can you create between each of those fingers? Those same positions of spread hands will create your down dog. Spread the hand out, bring it down, roll up into cat. Walk the hands underneath your shoulders, come into cow, nice deep breath. And exhale back into cat. Let's do that two more times, really checking in with that breath, the quality. And see if you can maybe deepen the inhale, feel your body expanding, and then follow that long exhale. Once you're in cat, point the toes and sit back over those legs, nice and strong, reaching out in front of you. Deep breath here. Drop your head all the way down. And walk to the right of your mat, off to the side, push into the ground and drop your nose. Take a breath into those outer ribs. And then again, moving to the other side and doing the same thing. Drop your head to your knee and feel the body. Receive the pose and feel how good it is to move your breath into your outer ribs. We'll come back to the center and do one more stretch, hips all the way back, but this time lift the heel of your palm and hand up. Push into the pads of the fingers and draw that head out towards your thumbs. Good. Let's roll up into a seated folded leg pose. Hands on your lower back. Gaze up brightly. Pull the shoulders back. Good. Good, and then walk yourself back to table. Nice deep breath here. Let's lift up one of our arms to the sky and look up, opening your chest and reaching as high as you can. And bring it on down. And then do the other arm lifted as high as you can. Look up. And bring it on down. Walking into half dog next, taking your hands out in front of you. And a nice easy drop of the chest and head. Keep those hips right above your knees as you take two more deep breaths. Feel a strong presence in your arms. Push into the earth with your hands. Fill up the body with an expanded breath and then a long exhale out. Finish here. Walking your hands back underneath, we're going to take an extension on one of our legs. Press all the way back. Drop the toe to the earth and push back into your calf. And just give your head a little shake. This right here, just letting your head down, shake out anything that just isn't going to be a service during this practice today. Stay light, stay positive. Inhale with a bright straight leg again, and then bend the knee, tucking it right behind the knee that's on the floor. Squeeze the inner thighs and drop that foot. And then try to draw your body weight back towards the foot you just dropped. So you're at an angle now. Maybe take a few adjustments back, and then some of you are going to come all the way back, dropping your head down to your front knee. Again, push into those hands on the floor, take a full breath, and notice how your hips are opening in this stretch. Rise back up, pressing down with your knee and lifting the extended same leg again, look up. And then you're going to stretch that foot all the way back, load it down to the earth, and then lift your arm up in the air and look at it. So in this side balance, I want you to practice opening up your outside body by dropping that top arm over your head, bicep close to the ear, and open here. So you might wave that top arm around a little bit just to get into some of the stretches of the shoulder that feel good to you. And then place your hand right behind your head, hold your head, and try to look up at the ceiling. And then pull that elbow away from your extended leg. Great, reach up to the ceiling now and let's balance here. Maybe adding a bind, bending the knee, grabbing that ankle and kicking the foot away. Maintain a deep breath here. And deep breath. Reaching the arm and leg out, and try to keep your leg up as you drop your hand down. Hold here. Curl your back toe under, and let's come into three-legged dog. Just briefly stretch up and step back with that foot into down dog. Let's pedal around. Inhale and exhale. Swing your hips. Inhale. Swing your hips. Exhale. One more breath, and then you'll join me back on hands and knees. All the way back. Choosing the opposite leg, extend it out now. Hold for a moment, and then drop the toe, flex foot. Push back and give your head another good shake as you drop it. Look forward, lift that leg up with your next deep breath. Look as high as you can, and then bend the knee. We're going to stretch the hip on the other side. Bring the knee across, drop it to the opposite side of the knee that's on the floor, and then drop your foot. And then we're just going to work our way back towards that foot we just dropped. So you might just stay in motion here, or you might take a moment to see if you can drop all the way back to that foot. Head down to the knee, and then strong arms. Push down with your palms. Drop your head as low as you can and then feel what's going on in the stretch of your hips. So in this yoga practice, we're never looking for something not to feel good. It's always about how good is it feeling and how can we make it feel even better. So we're looking to lighten, brighten, strengthen, and create good sensations. So if something doesn't feel good, I'm just going to simply say don't do it. Join me back up, rising up, stand that leg back out, And then we'll come into that balance. Stretch the leg away from you, drop your foot, and then lift your arm up in the air, look up. And then let's try to stretch the side of our body by extending that arm as far as you can, bicep close to the ear and breathing here. Good. Take your hand behind your head now. Try to turn the gaze to the ceiling and pull the elbow away from your extended leg again. Notice how good that feels. And then reach up to the ceiling if you'd like to try balance. Still looking up nice and bright and maybe adding the bind, grabbing your ankle and kicking back. Good. Here we're just trying to maintain that flow of breath. Noticing how good this feels to be present. Returning to extension, trying to keep that leg straight as you return back down. Table with extended leg, curl the toes under that's on the floor, and briefly come into a three-legged dog, just a nice bright stretch up, and then let the leg come down and let's let our hips swing right to left as we pedal through each heel again. Nice work, everybody. Shake your head here, look through your legs behind you, and join me in plank when you're ready. Modified plank, hands and knees is always an option. When you arrive, I want you to move around a little bit, find some strength and awareness of how your breath is helping you. Maybe even push forward and back a few times. And then lean forward nice and bright. If your knees are down, same thing. We're going to come into a stretch of our hand to the ceiling. Open up, side plank, deep breath. Arm comes back down as you exhale. Again, knees can be down if you need them down. Reach the opposite arm up, move around. Exhale the arm back down. And then we'll lean forward again, dropping the knees into our cobra. So lower on down, toes on the floor, shoulders rolling back, gaze forward. Roll down, extending the heart forward as you drop your nose, and then come back into cobra, trying to maintain strength in the middle back, not the lower back. Exhale down, and if you're ready, up dog, if not, cobra again. Good, engage the core. Lift it up towards the sky and sit back over your heels. Ha. Take a moment and just rock right to left. Inhale and exhale. And then join me in down dog. All right, let's go ahead and move our practice to the top of our mat. Small steps, taking your time, arriving at the top of the mat or using your modification, arriving from hands and knees and stepping your foot through. When you do arrive, let's come back to being soft, easy swings right to left. We're still in our theme of soft and strong and just recognizing that both are valuable and effective in creating positive change in our body. Come back to the center, fingers are on the floor, knees are probably bent for most of us, and maybe take a grab of those calves, push into them with your hands and drop your nose as close to your knees as you can. Good, and then take your fingertips to the front of the shins and come into a half lift, nice extended gaze out, holding a straight back, finding one more deep breath here as you lift your tailbone a little higher, and then down, and we'll roll up when you're ready. Press into the feet. Some of you might place your hands on your lap to come up, hands over the head, full stretch. So when you arrive in this stretch, let's just be as soft for a moment and then arrive strong on your next inhale. Big stretch, look up, thumbs to the back of the room, and pull them back as you look up. Exhale, bring your hands to your heart. Swing down, come outside and all the way back up. Exhale down, let's do it again. Drop your head lower, come all the way up, and exhale your hands to your heart. Good, let's do a vinyasa flow. Nice and easy, the first one. Hands at your sides. Swing out in front, thumbs to the back of the room. Nice full breath lifts you there. Exhale, soft spine to a fold. Bow your head as close to your knees. And then half lift, look out front. Drop onto your hands and step back to plank. Hold your plank. If you're ready, add chaturanga. Up dog or that cobra we already practiced. And then lift the navel up and back into child's pose. Downward facing dog, take your time. Lift your hips high, drop your head down low, and extend that back. Making your way back to the top of the mat, take your time when you get there, soften and swing. Here we go, we're back to the soft edges. Head down lower. On your next inhale, half lift extension. Exhale to a deeper fold. And rise with a deep breath. Inhale, hands over your head. Exhale into your heart. Let's do that again. Swing those hands into a back bend that feels good to you. Exhale through a soft spine down. Inhale to a half lift. Step back onto hands and knees or plank. Add chaturanga if you're doing those today. Up dog or cobra. And child's pose. Let's try it one more time. If you need a break, stay in child's pose. Down dog, stepping to the top of the mat, into a fold and a soft edge swing. Half lift extension, deeper fold, rise up, deep breath, exhale to the heart. Swing the hands into a bright extended back bend. Exhale through center and back to a fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, back into plank. Holding plank or adding your chaturanga. Upward dog or cobra. Use your core to drive your hips back into child's pose. And we'll return to down dog. Good job, everybody. Let's walk our hands back towards our feet and into a forward fold here. Head down, give it a good shake. And come into a squat that fits your body today. And then back to fold. We'll just do that two more times. So modifier, your squat might look like this. And then fingers on the floor for your fold. Everybody, one more time. And then head down, hands down, walk into plank. And walk back. So I'm gonna have you do that a few times. An easier version would be to walk into down dog. Stronger version into plank. Feel the plank before coming back. And one more time, be strong with your arms, your breath, your core, and your thoughts. The next time you come back into your fold, stay there, bow. Coming back into plank, hold plank or side plank on each side. Again, you can always drop your knees for this one. Through your mini vinyasa, up dog, and child's pose. And then let's return to our down dog. At any time you need a break, please feel free to take it. So from down dog, I'm going to have you take one more breath, and we're going to shorten this down dog quite a bit. So you're going to walk your feet towards the center of your mat until your heels drop, and then you're going to drop heavy onto your heels, and then press into your finger beds, trying to drive those hips back over your heels. When you're ready, lift your toes, stretch them. Keep the spine extending all the way up to your tailbone, but pull your body weight back in your heels. Big stretch, yeah? Let's walk back one more step. Pick up your right heel and step across the left foot. Widen your hands and push back into the heels here. Big stretch behind that leg. Head down. Good. Pick up that right heel, step back over your foot. Pick up your left heel, step over. Move the hands out wide and lean back into your heels, lifting your toes. Big stretch up and down the back of those legs and hips. Knees can be bent here if it's just too much. And then bring your foot back neutral and walk your feet to your hands. So we're right in the middle of our mats in a forward fold. Let's take a roll up. Take your time. Some of you are going to do better with your hands on your lap as you roll up. Hands on your lower back. Look to the ceiling into a gentle back bend. And then curl the chin back to the throat. Draw the hands down the legs and back into a fold. We're going to repeat that with or without help in our arms. Inhale, look up, come into a gentle back bend, looking up. Curl it on down and come down. We'll do one more with a full deep breath, everybody. Inhale, hold, exhale, and drop. And then inhale to standing, hands over your head. Good. So I'm going to turn and face you, palms together, working ourselves into star. So feet are at least the same width as your shoulders, if not wider. Hands mimic the feet, and you're going to take a deep breath, stretching from center out, radiating all that is you, making you as big as you can, and then exhaling your hands to your heart. Try it one more time. Inhale to star and hold. Exhale, bring it into your heart. All right, some leg work coming up next. So toes slightly pointed out, heels in, and you're gonna bring your arms out and hold a couple of plates right in front of you and start to bend the knees as we arrive in horse. So horse is a squatted pose. Our knees are following our toes, so you wouldn't want your knees to collapse in here, but rather keep them nice and brightly opened. Shoulders are down. You're taking another full breath as I hold you in this squat. And then we'll do a series of extensions back to the squat. So lift up, find those fingertips, place them strong together, and then exhale into strong horse. Whatever that means for you today. So some of you can get this horse way on down on that exhale, feel and pause, and then come back up for that bright stretch. So you have time for one more. I want you to feel strong as you inhale. Come into horse as you exhale. Hold here or lift those heels in a balance so you're only on the balls of the feet. So if both up is just too much for you today, maybe try one of them up. Good. Another strong breath here. Heels are still up if you're in the balance. Brighten your core. Drop the heels. Come up. Grab your wrist and take a big side bend. Use your core to come back up. Grab the opposite wrist and pull it over for a side bend. That feels good, huh? Inhale, come up, both hands together. Exhale to your heart. Good. So I'm going to have you point your right toe. Keep your left foot at a parallel to the back of your mat. And then open up your arms. You're coming into your warrior two. So just move for a moment, kind of moving your hips into the deepest, strongest pose. Start soft and strong, palms up, deep breath. And then move your hand back into extended arm, peaceful warrior. Swing that arm loosely down, and then see if you can lift it even higher, bigger stretch. Beautiful, back to your warrior two. Look over your front hand, deepen that lunge. Bring that elbow down and swing your back hand behind your back. So most of us, this will be good. We'll stay right here, pushing into the elbow on the thigh and looking up over your top shoulder. And if you'd like, come into a bind. Hand comes underneath the thigh, arm grabs that hand and hold. Bringing your tailbone down towards the earth and your head towards the front of the room. One more breath in whatever pose you chose. Push into your front foot and come back to your warrior two. And then all the way back up, shifting the feet and exhaling back into horse. Good. Inhale, big floating stretch up, look up. Exhale, strong horse. Stay in horse, lift your heels for a second balance.
But let's take those arms bigger in this second balance. Tuck the tailbone a little. Use your breath. One more inhale and exhale. Stretch up as you drop your heels. Deep breath and right back into that horse. Good. Let's do everything on the other side. Turn your left toes out. Bring your right foot parallel to the back of the mat. And then bend the front knee a few times. Maybe even move it around. Start off soft. And then find a way to deep breathe into something strong feeling in your body. Powerful warrior two. Palms up as you breathe in. Exhale. Extend that front arm out over your head. Feel strong, peaceful warrior. Let that arm soften and drop, and then come up even stronger. Lift, extend, hold your peaceful warrior. And then return to warrior two, looking over your front middle finger. Drop your elbow, swing your back hand behind you, push into that elbow and look up, stay here or come into your bind. Find your way into the pose and then breathe deeply. Try looking at the ceiling. Notice where you feel strong. Push into your front foot. Come back to your warrior two. Look over that front middle hand. And then shift the feet. Come back into horse. Deep hold. Inhale up. Exhale, horse again. And your third attempt of lifting those heels. So heels up nice and bright. If they drop, just bring them back up. Try to pick up the knees. Squeeze down with the tailbone. Good, and then drop into your heels and come into star. Arms wide, look up, big stretch, deep breath. Exhale, hands to your heart. Good, I'm gonna have you shorten your stance a little bit, bring your heels and toes in. So you're still wide, but not as wide as we were on that. And then I'm gonna have you bring your arms out nice and straight. Let's take a deep breath here. Turn your thumbs to the back of the room, look up, stretch brightly. And then exhale the palms together in front of you as you bow your head. Good, deep breath again, thumbs back, open up, look up, feel even brighter in your arms and legs, followed by the exhale, head down, palms together. Draw the hands into the heart and then over your head. And let's come into a small bend of the knees. Arms out wide, we're gonna hinge at the hips and try to bring our back parallel to the floor in this squat. Some of you can straighten your legs, others of you feel better with the knees bent. Everybody lift your navel up against your spine. Beautiful, and drop just the finger pads on the floor below your heart, so tented hands. So for most people, probably your knees will be bent here. Everybody's back is flat. You're gonna lift your right arm up and look up. And bring it on down, hold the squat or straight legs and do the other side. Beautiful. Use your breath to return to the first arm coming up again. And down. Strong lift up. Soft return down. Let's try it one more time. More advanced people, reach across with the hand that's down, right out in front of the opposite foot. And soft down, opposite hand in front of the opposite foot, lift up strong, and down. Good, bring your hands back to the floor, heel toe in again just a little bit. Cross your arms over each other, grab the outside of your calves, and when you're ready, take a deep breath, pulling your head away from the floor, straightening the back. Knees can be bent here. Exhale, bend the elbows and drop your head down. Pull on those outer shin bones with your hands. Pull the elbows down towards the floor, along with the crown of your head. Inhale, come back up. Place your fingers on the floor and then cross your opposite arms and grab the shins. Inhale, try to look forward, straight spine, extension, lift the tailbone.
Exhale, drop your head, bend your elbows, try to extend the spine down as you push the finger pads into your outer calves. Try pushing into your outer heels at the same time now, a little stretch in those hips. And then soften, bend the knees and drop the hands. Great job. Let's bring our feet even more narrow as we come into a squat. So bend the knees. Some of you might need to bring your elbows onto your lap and just look forward, because coming into full flexion, if it hurts your knees, you just don't want to do that, right? Otherwise, fingers down and full flexion if that's available to you. Breath in and out. If you want to add a balance, hands, take your time raising them over your head. Gaze is up front and soft. Inhale and exhale. Hands to the heart. And hands behind you all the way as we sit back onto our sit bones. Alrighty, let's go ahead and come into cobbler, soles of the feet together. And just rock right to left a little bit. Find a nice, easy, soft movement here. And when you're ready, you'll grab a hold of your feet or your ankles and try to bend the elbows forward. And then exhale a strong stretch of the head down to the toes. Practice breathing into the back muscles and expanding them upon your inhale. And then dropping your head lower on your exhale. Good. Roll up slowly. Keep your right foot in, extend the left leg into a straddle and bring that right foot closer to your left leg. Again, just an easy, soft rocking here. And you'll get your left hand to lay in front of your left leg. We're going to try to lower our left elbow, but it doesn't mean it'll happen today. Take a breath and stretch your right hand away from your left hand. Look up. And then follow your hand over your left foot. Big stretch. Try to drop into that left elbow, touching the floor if you can with your left elbow. I feel like I can hear some of the giggling on that comment. Remember, you're just here to do you, as always. Inhale and exhale. And then raise that hand back up, right hand up, and place it nice and firm on the floor behind your right hip. And lift your left arm up, and you're an extension on the spine. Your gaze is up, your left arm is strong. And some of you will rise up with the tailbone as you press into your shin and left foot and reach to the back of the room. Big stretch here. Feel strong in how you rise up through the lower body. Let your head fall back soft. One more breath here. When you're ready, you'll let that top arm just float down as you lower your hips. And then we'll switch sides. Take your time. Right leg is straight, straddled. Left foot is in. We're just going to move around. Right hand to the inside. Our goal is to lower our right elbow when we can. And here we go. Left arm, deep breath. Reach away from your right hand. And then follow it over your head towards your right foot. Inhale and exhale. Again, find your right elbow. Try to lower it, maybe to the floor today. Inhale and exhale. Notice where this feels good. Open up, breathe into any of the sensations that you're experiencing in this pose. One more breath. Lifting up with the hand nice and tall. And then drop your left hand behind your hip. Strong press into the earth. Right hand up nice and strong. Feel extension and maybe lift that tailbone. Dropping your right toe. Reaching back. Going for this big stretch the best you can. Inhale and exhale. Let your neck and jaw soften. Lower body strengthen. Finish up this last breath, and then we'll softly bring it back down. Good job. Feet out in front of you. Drop your head right over those bent knees. Reach for your toes and bow your head. Take a deep breath into those shoulder blades and exhale. Sit up nice and tall. Extension on the spine. Try lifting your toes. If you want to join me in full boat pose anytime you're ready. Otherwise, just practice leaning back with a straight, strong presence in your abdominals. Strong drive down towards center with those muscles. Heels are light. Full boat. You can always come up when you're ready. We have two more breaths wherever you've decided to be. And I'm going to ask you to lift your eyes and look up. One more of those full breaths. And a soft exit out. Easy drop of the head forward. And we're going to drop on back. So we're going to get ready for our Shavasana. Take your time. Come onto your spine. Rolling back strong or soft, whatever works best for you. And ending with your knees and your chest. And just rolling around. So hopefully you've landed on your back and you've improved your attitude. I know it really helps me, even if it isn't 100% fix. It is totally a fix in the right direction. Happy baby option, simply pulling those shins apart or grabbing inner outer foot. Feeling nice and relaxed in your hips as you try to drop your tailbone with a deep belly breath. Good, knees back into the chest. Let's do a twist to each side. Arms out wide. For those of you who need a modification in twisting, drop your feet first. And we're all going to take our knees to the right and let them just stack and fall. Less or more, whichever one feels better. And turn your head in the opposite direction for two breaths. Using your core to come back up, either just feet on the floor or knees over the chest, and then stack in the opposite direction, less or more, doesn't matter. Just make it feel good to you. Two breaths here, turning your head in the opposite direction. Notice how good it feels upon that inhale, and then following it inward on your exhale. One last hug, wrap your arms around your knees and maybe bring your nose up to them. Hold on tight, give yourself a good hug. And then safely place your head back as we find our way into Shavasana. I'm going to demonstrate constructive hip pose. Feet wide on the edges of the mat, knees bent, and then just let the knees fall inward without any effort. Let them just spill. Hands relaxed, shoulders down your back, arms open. Again, you can bring your legs into any pose that feels good to you. And you're going to take one more deep breath, just looking up, reminding yourself today to take moments to look up, to brighten, to inspire yourself to do good, and then close your eyes. Pause with your deep breaths here. Eyes are soft like blankets. And then let go of controlling your breath. Let it just be whatever it is. And simply observe it. Be a witness to the beauty of whatever your breath is right now. Feel your back getting heavier as you relax, softening throughout the body. No need to be strong here, allowing yourself to soften with each exhale. head to toe. Take a moment to be grateful for whatever is showing up for you today. To choose to look at things with a brighter outlook. Thank yourself for showing up for yourself today. I thank you as well. When you're ready, gently move into a stretch, finding your way back to a seated pose. Drawing your hands comfortably in front of you, bowing your head. Notice how you might have succeeded in shifting that attitude just to feeling better, even if it's just a little. That's a win. Thank you, Four Corners, for allowing this time for us to practice together. Thank you all for joining me. Namaste.